Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy, back with another episode today. Probably one of the most controversial things in owning a desktop laser is getting your speed and power dialed in. In this video today, I'm going to show you how to do that with 100% accuracy and not burn up all of your materials like I did when I first started. Now, there are a lot of videos out there on creating a grid and how to create a grid. However, they don't get into the details about how you should burn it and what parts of the grid you should use for what materials. So that's what we're going to cover today. Now, you have to have some experience testing different materials to get an idea of how to use a grid, which I've got. So I'm going to share that experience with you today, and hopefully it'll help you get a more consistent power scale burn, so you'll know what powers and what speeds to use on your diode laser. Now, this applies just to diode lasers. So let's get started. The very first thing that we're going to do is create a grid. And after we create the grid, you're going to see how to use what we've just created. So anybody can show you how to create a grid, but I'm going to show you how to actually use it. So we're going to start by coming up here to the rectangle tool. I'm going to grab a rectangle. I'm going to hold shift and drag out a square. And there we have our first square, and we're going to put that on layer one. The next thing we're going to do is create a grid. So we're going to come down here to create an array of objects. We're going to click on that, and we're going to, with the diode laser, you really 10 and 20% you'll hardly use, but let's say sometimes you will use 20%. So we'll start with this one at 20%, and we'll do one for 30 40 50 60 70 80 90 100. So now we have 9 different ones here, and we're going to use several different powers, and you can edit this any way that you like. You can follow this tutorial and create your own, or you can download a copy of this one when I'm finished, and I'll put a link down below in the description to my website where you can download it for free. So on the rows, we're going to start, most commonly this first row is going to be about 1,000, and we're talking about creating a grid for a vector graphic. So we're going to start off at about 1,000 speed. And then we're going to go 1200, 1400, 1600, 1800, 2000, 25, and 3000 speed. And we're going to say OK. Now that we've got our grid, we're going to come over here to the text tool, select it, and start at 1000. And then we'll go 1200 and 1400, 1600, 1800. 2000, 2500, and 3000. And your speeds may vary. So now I'm going to press the escape key twice, and I'm at my selector tool, and I'm just going to move them to approximately the right area. I'm just pretty much centering these on, or getting close to it. This doesn't really matter where they are. You just want them to be sort of in the right general area. Okay, so now that we've got that, we're going to select all of these, and we're going to come up here and align these along their vertical centers. And when I did that, now they're all straight up and down. So now we've got our power scale. Another thing too we're going to do is put these, we're going to put these on the 00 layer. And now at the top here, we're going to put our power scale. So we're going to come back to the selector tool, and we're going to put 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. And again, we'll just grab it, move it about to the middle. And you can speed this part up if you want. Just press the right arrow key and it'll speed up the video. And then again, what we're going to do now is drag over these, and we're going to line these along their horizontal. All right, so there we go. We've got our grid. Now, at this point, what we're going to do is we're going to come up here. We'll move the labels up to the top. So we have 00, 01. Now, on the 00, we're going to leave 1250 is good, and I'll show you why in a minute when we customize this. On the 01 layer, we're going to make our speed 1000, this entire layer. So we're going to do 1000, and we're going to do 100%, and I'm going to explain that in a minute. For the next layer, we're going to select it. We're going to put it on the 02 layer. And let's just go down and move all of these to the right layer, 03, 04, 05, 6, 7, and 8. And there we go. We've got all of our layers. We've got the first two done. We're going to come into the third one, make our speed. Now, if we just move this off to the side, you'll see that our speed is going to be 1200. And we'll come to the green layer, and that is 1400. Then we'll come to the whatever color that is. And that one is 1600. And then we'll come to the orange, and that one is 1800. And then we'll come to the blue is 2000, which it already is. And number 7 is 2500, and that one's good. And number 8 is 3000. And there we go. So I'll just come back here just to check them. 12, 14, 18, 2000, 2500. And 3000, and that's good. And every one of these has to be at 100% power. Okay, now we're good to go. However, if I preview this, you'll see everything burns the same, so that's not what we're looking to do. So now what we're going to do is separate out the powers. We're going to come across here, select this entire row, this 20% row, and we're going to come over here on the right to shape properties. And the shape, in the shape properties, we're going to power scale this to 20% of the 100. So this entire row will burn at 20%. Okay. Now we're going to do the same thing for the second row, and we're going to change it to 30%. And we're going to go across the entire graphic, going one by one, changing them to the appropriate numbers. So 40% and 50%. Percent 60% 70% 80%. And this is one of the nice things about lightburn is this power scaling. And this one's 100%. Now, if we take a look, we'll burn left to right from 20% power, 30, 40, all the way across to 100 at this speed. And the same thing here at this speed. So now, this is good to go, or is it? Here's the thing that all newbies get stuck on. They'll take this power grid and they'll burn it onto a piece of material, whether it be wood or leather, or paper, or whatever it may be. And let me tell you what, you're going to ignite paper at anything over 20 on this power scale. So you don't want to do that. So what you have to understand about creating a power scale is that you have to optimize it. So if we come over here to cuts and layers, and we're going to, let's say we're going to make some black slate coasters. Okay, this is where you have to have like a little experience. So I'm going to put a list of my settings in here for the ortur 20 watt laser in the notes section of this file. So it will open automatically when you open the file. But if you just go file, show notes, there's the notes section. And that's embedded in the file. I'm going to include my settings in here for you to use as a baseline for testing yours. As I said, the example is black slate. Now I know that black slate burns absolutely beautiful on my 20 watt laser at 1200 speed and 90 power. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this 1200 speed, and that's the only one that I'm going to turn on, because that's the, or you can turn on 1200, you know, 1400, you could even do 1000. So I will come up here to cuts and layers, and I will activate only the outline. In fact, we could do 1000, 1200, 1400, right? But I will turn off the output on the rest of these, and you see how they grayed out? So now the only thing that's gonna burn is gonna be these first three, because we know on slate, or I know on slate, that from about 1600 on up, you're not going to get very, very much. So it's a waste of time to have the laser go back and forth and do all of this when it's not going to come out right. I have a baseline of 1290. I'm going to use this entire area right here, these first three, to run my test burn on the slate. And if we come up here and preview it now, you'll see this is exactly what's going to burn. We've eliminated all of that wasted time here. You're good to go for your test on slate. Now, if we were to turn these back on, and let's say that we were doing a bamboo piece of wood or a cutting board, bamboo cutting board. So I know that what's worked well for me in the past is 700 speed, 80 power for line, and 1000 speed, 80 power for fill. So what I'm gonna do if I were doing bamboo, and again, you can reference the notes that I'll put up in here for you. For bamboo cutting board, I'm gonna go from 1000 to 1400, and these are the three that I'm going to use. So again, it's going to be the same thing. I'm going to turn off everything except for the first three rows, well, the first four rows in this case. And you'll get a good idea when this burns of how well it's going to come out on your project. Now, I found that for all softwoods, I'm just going to burn these first three rows. And actually, I might even turn this first row down to 700. So you can change these just by coming up in here and, you know, put 700 in there. And you can put 900 here and 1,000 here and 1,200 there and just burn the first four rows. So this is completely customizable, and this will give you a good head start. Now, another product that I burn quite a bit is cork. I make a lot of cork coasters, and I sell these online in the Facebook marketplace. And I found that my best speed is 1000 speed and about 20 to 30. So what I'm going to do is I'm only going to turn on the very first line, turn everything else off over here. The only thing that's going to burn is this very first line, because I know that cork, I'm going to scorch it when I start getting up past here. So while it's burning, I'll actually keep an eye on it, and I'll throw away one coaster on this power test. So when you burn this power scale, it's going to work somewhere in between 20, 30, 40. And that's really all you need. You can stop your laser when you see it starting to burn. And this is the thing that nobody tells you, because they tell you here, create a power scale, have all of these turned on, and you're gonna burn up a lot of material and waste a lot of time and consume a lot of the energy from your laser, which is a disposable, and it will degrade over time. So if you keep burning this 80, 90, 100% on every test burn that you do, your laser is not gonna last very long. And I can tell you, if you don't have a power rating on your laser, if you look at it and it doesn't tell you what the lifetime of the laser is, it's probably gonna be 20 to 30 hours. So you really don't wanna waste all of that energy and kill the life of your laser. Now, if you're working with an ortur, their lifetime is 10,000 hours. So, but that's at a 50% rating. So you don't wanna waste the life of the laser by burning things that are totally unnecessary. Now with acrylic, for example, and I'm going to use a black or orange acrylic, they burn about the same. Well, what I'm going to do is change my power on line one. I'm going to change my speed to 100 instead of 1000, and I'm going to put my power at 100 and say okay. Now I'll turn off everything else that's on here except for that first line. And now this first line will be 100. So it'll be 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, which probably won't do too much, but you'll start to engrave at about 60%. And 70 is, you'll get a good engraving, or somewhere in here. You're probably gonna wind up somewhere in the 50 to 80% range for engraving. And I think on mine, I'd be about 50 for etching, and I'd be somewhere around 90, 100 speed and 90 for cutting. And you have to be really focused to do that. So that is the secret of the power scale. And you're not going to find this anywhere else. And I don't quite understand why, because you're wasting so much material. If you were to run this power scale on leather, for example, your entire first row is going to burn all the way through. I mean, from 50% on up, it's going to burn all the way through. And you won't start getting the results that you want in this higher power range until you get up to about 2500. Between 2000 and 3000 is where you're gonna do your engraving on leather. If you wanted to cut it, you'd be somewhere in this range here, around 1280, maybe 1480 or 90, something like that. And cutting leather is a completely different thing, because all leathers are different, all diode lasers are different, and you want to definitely run a good power scale on that, because more power doesn't necessarily mean better cutting. It's the clean edges that you want. If ever you run the power scale on leather, or whenever you cut or engrave on leather, you should always use some painter's masking tape and cover the leather with that first, and then run your power scale. And this way you'll get clean cuts, no burning on the leather that you have to wash off. And then you just look for the actual sides of the cut to see which one is the cleanest. And sometimes lower power and higher speed is the cleanest cut. And there you have it. This is really a simple process. Anyone can do this. And I'm going to include the file that you can download from my website for free. So if you get stuck anywhere along the way, just come back and review the video again, and you'll see how to set this up for your test burn. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like and subscribe, and leave a comment down below. Thank you for watching.